Hey there, buddy! It's Tata Kopi, welcome to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix. The last time, we continued our work through the castle, and along the way, we encountered Saix, and, you know, he told us we were no use, you know, for Kingdom Hearts, and to summon, like, this huge army of Heartless against us. But then, as soon as we were, like, surrounded, Kairi decided to join the battle, and also, she also had a Keyblade. And the name for Keyblade that she got is called Destiny's Embrace. And I kind of like that Keyblade. It looks kind of cool, and it's perfect for Kairi, you know? And so, yeah, we also know that, you know, Peter and Maleficent are here, and, you know, Maleficent is intent on taking this castle for her very own. And, yeah, we'll just let her do what she wants for now. But then also, Mickey also met Ansem the Wise, and Ansem told us, you know, everything. You know, all he wanted to do, this whole thing, was just for revenge against his apprentices in Xehanort, or Xemnas, you want to call him, and also how Riku came to be like this form, you know, like Ansem. And then after that, Zigbar decided to show up, you know, to fight against us, to teach us a lesson, but joke's on him, we taught him a lesson instead, and we defeated him. And then after we defeated Zigbar, we were finally reunited with our friends. And like I said last episode, you know, that whole scene is misinterpreted. They keep on people thinking like Sora's gay for Riku just because of that one moment where he's crying. I tried to explain to you guys the reason why that's not true. And yeah, with our friends reunited, we're continuing to make our way onward. And yeah. Now, before we go, as you can see, we can't go yet because of this barrier here. And the only way to unlock the barrier is to... There's two rooms here, or I'll explain this, but... Basically, last episode I said, this is basically like a graveyard of the fallen members of Organization 13. As you can see, the red means is that they're gone, but the blue means that they're alive. So in this case, we have... Hold on, let's go through top to bottom. Okay, so first we have the Whirlwind Lancer, which is Zaldin. The Free Shooter, which is Zigbar, which we defeated last episode. The Chilly Academic, Vexen, which Axel, you know, killed. The Silent Hero, which is Lexius, in which, you know, Riku, you know, killed him. And this one doesn't have a symbol, it's basically destroyed, but basically the Cloaked Schemer, and that is Zexion. And I don't know why his is destroyed and doesn't show his symbol. I don't know why they did that. The Luna Diviner, which is Saix, as you can see it's blue, which means he's alive. Which means you're gonna have to deal with him as well. Key of Destiny, which is Roxas. And his is blue for some reason, but we can't go through. So it's like they're saying Roxas is alive, but not alive in a sense as we can like see him, but alive in a sense that he's with Sora, I guess you could say. The Savage Nymph. Yes, Larxene, who I despise so much. Like I said before, like, they should have renamed the title. Instead of Savage Nymph, they should have called it the Savage Bitch. The Graceful Assassin. Ah, yes. Marluxia. The traitors of the organization, along with Larxene. And we don't know what happened in Chain of Memories, you know. Gambler of Fate, which is Luxord, and that's the room we're going to have to go through. So we're really facing against Luxord. No, this one. The Melodious Nocturne, that's how you say it. And that is Demix. Oh, with this, you know, dance, mortar, dance! Oh, yes. The fight that everyone hates so much. And Flurry of dancing flames. Axel. Why, Axel? I can't believe you're gone. It sucks. You were so cool. And now you're just gone. I mean, if he didn't sacrifice himself, would we have to destroy him? I don't know. I mean, sure, we wanted to take down the organization, but I don't know. Maybe we could have kept Axel alive, at least. Oh, well. And of course, there's Xemnas, but Xemnas doesn't have his grave here. So yeah, we have all 12 members of the organization. And yeah, that's basically all the members. So now, like I said, we're gonna take care of Luxord, since, you know, his is blue, which means he's gonna be alive, but not for long. Soon, his is gonna be red, just like the others. Alright, before we do that, let's prepare for a fight. Okay, yep, okay. Okay, I should be good. What do you have to say, Kairi? I don't like the feel of this place. It's almost like a graveyard. Just about everything is in ruins. Do you know what it all means, Sora? Yep. This is the graveyard of the organization's members. And what do you have to say, Riku? Some members of Organization 13 see fighting as a game. No matter what the rules are, you'll always have a chance to win. Don't miss that chance. So yeah, basically he's just getting a tip of how to, you know, face off against Luxord, but you know what, we could do it. Alright, enough staying around. Let's do this. Get ready, Luxord. Your time has come.
What's that?
It's the King and Diz. I mean, Ansem the Wise. They must be higher up. We better hurry.
Well then, let's go. Or not.
You!
I'd rather we just skip the formalities.
Fine by me. So yeah, this boss fight is kind of unusual. So basically, it's the battle for time. Win the battle for time. So tips, this is a time-based battle. Finish off the enemy when their time gauge runs out. If Sora runs out of time, HP or time, it's game over. Alright, then I basically know the rules, so let's do it.
The first to run out of time is the loser.
Alright then. Oh my god, what? Why my dice? No! Oh my god, this is weird. Ow, 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 ow. Hey, stop that. Go away. Why are we at dice? So weird. Come on. Wait for it. There we go.
A challenge. Do you know the rules?
Crap. So yeah, sometimes Luxord will do some like a thing where you like, in this fight there's gonna be X's or O's commands, and for that sequence, if I got an O command, then his time would be decreased, but for me, I got an X, my time was decreased, and I was turned into a card. Try that again. Come on. Come on. Wait for it. Crap! Ah! I'm too slow! Damn it! This sucks! Holy shit! Oh, I see. Okay. Where are you? Found you.
It's over! It's over! Back off!
Where are you? Where are you? Gotcha!
Back off.
Where are you? Oh, uh-huh. Found you.
Oh, this is it.
Come on, try that trick again. Come on. I know I can do it. Come on. Come on.
Do you know the rules?
Yes, there we go. Much better.
Take this. This is it.
But yeah, this fight is basically just a luck of chance and getting it right, or hitting the buttons right.
Do you know the rules?
Aha! Yes! Much better. Alright, I'm getting the hang of it.
Look who's on top of the game.
Oh, now he's serious. Oh boy. Run! Nope. Go away. No. No, leave me alone. Oh boy, this part. Yes! And? Yes. Oh man, but that last part, getting four O's, is really tricky, but I'm actually getting my first try. Whew, I didn't think I could do it. But I did. You are finished, Luxord. Ooh.
How could you, Roxas?
That's Sora!
That's the second time they called us Roxas. First it was Zigbar, and now Luxord.
You okay?
Yeah, no worries. Let's keep moving.
Ooh, secret answer port number 9. I'll probably read that at the end of the episode. Oh man, I didn't think I would get those four O's, you know, in this fight, but somehow I managed to do it. Oh, Fooey, I was all ready and raring to go, but I didn't get a chance to fight. We really can't tell what's going to happen. Keep your guard up. But alright, Donald. I promise the next fight you will be in it. Trust me. I wonder how far the king went. I know he's strong enough to take care of himself, but I'm still worried. Don't worry, he'll be okay. Hmm. Not bad, Sora. You've grown stronger. You don't need my weapon, Soul Eater, or the power of the dark yet. Roxas. I know that name. Once I spoke with him, he reminded me of you, Sora. Who is he? Oh yes, at the very beginning when Ensign told us that, you know, that Roxas and Kairi, you know, had a brief exchange, and that Sora gave, you know, Kairi's, you know, that Sora told Kairi his name, and he said, starts with an S, and that's when Kairi remembered Sora's name. But yeah, that was like way in the beginning. And what do you know? The next room is open, and guess who's waiting for us? Yep, it's Saix. And as you can see, it's red now, because he's dead. Uh-huh, too bad. So now only two remain. Man, like, we've just reduced our numbers already that quick, jeez. Look, now this entrance is glowing. Could this have something to do with your enemy, Sora? I could sense Saix. He's using something to boost his power. If we could figure out his power source, we may be able to use it too. Oh, I have been waiting for this fight. Oh man, Saix, you were such an asshole. I mean, you were a jerk to Axel. You even, like, held Kairi hostage, and we even begged you to, you know, we could see her. You said, nope, fuck you, you're not gonna see her. And you just pissed us off so many times, and you know what? I'm finally happy to put you in your place. Oh, I just can't wait to take you down. I despise you. but not as much as I despise Larxene. But regardless, I still despise you, and I will take you down. I hope you're ready for your imminent defeat. Alright, before we go, let's see. Alright, same as always. Alright then, everything ready? Alright then, let's go. Get ready, Saix. We're coming for you.
Only you could have made it this far in one piece, Roxas.
Really? Again?
That's really getting old.
Yeah, he's slower.
Different name, same fate.
Jeez, Saix is not playing around. But you know what? So are we.
Do you feel it? The moon's power.
Moon, shine down.
Oh, I've been waiting for this, Saix. Now, as you can see, he has like a berserk bar, and the only way to counter it is if we use his own weapon against him. Which is basically kind of similar to, you know, the Berserker Nobodies. You know, using their own weapons against them. We're doing the same thing, but with Saix. Yes! Oh, I've been waiting for this, Saix.
No way.
This is all for you. This is for everything you've done. Stop hitting me. Let me finish you off. Come on. Okay. Whoa. Wait for it. Oh, I missed. Crap. Yeah.
I misjudged you.
Oh yeah. What? Let's try to use this again. Come on. Yes. Ah, yes. Feels so good to take you down. Oh boy. Ow. Yeah. Gotcha. Oh boy. Ow. Would you stop that? Come on. Fall, you bastard. Fall. Crap. Oh, come on, let me grab it. Oh, shit. This is his final desperation move. Holy shit. Damn. Jesus, calm down. You need to take a chill pill. Alright, wait for it. Yes. Now, fall. Come on. Heal. Die, you son of a bitch. Yes. We finally took him down. It's over, Saix. You lost.
Kingdom Hearts. Where is my heart?
Oh well, too bad for you. You don't get one. And at last, Saix falls.
I don't get it. Why has everybody been calling me Roxas?
Because, Sora. Roxas is your nobody.
My nobody? But that's crazy. I never turned into a heart.
You did.
Oh, right.
It was when you came to rescue me. Remember?
Xemnas was the one who found Roxas. He could use the Keyblade because he was your nobody. That's why Xemnas brought him into the organization. But Roxas betrayed them. After that, I fought him because I thought it would help you wake up. I lost. But the next time we met, I made sure I was the stronger one.
So yeah, we now know that Roxas is Sora's nobody, because you remember, you know, he became a Heartless, and thus his nobody was created, which was Roxas. And here we get a flashback of what happened between the fight between Riku and Roxas.
You quit.
Come on, Sora. I thought you were stronger than that.
Huh? Get real. Look which one of us is winning.
So it's true. You really are his nobody. Guess Diz was right after all.
What are you talking about? I am me. Nobody else. How many times do I have to beat you?
All right. You've left me with no other choice.
What?
I have to release the power in my heart. The dark power that I've been holding back. Even if it changes me forever.
Accepted it.
I mean, it was kind of a cheap trick using the Guardian, but you know, Riku had to do it, no matter the cost.
Diz, he could feel Sora.
Oh, he told you how he felt, did he? Ridiculous. And nobody cannot feel anything.
If he had met Sora, things might have been different.
Maybe I didn't need to fight him after all. I think he left the organization because he really wanted to meet you.
Roxas. I wish I could meet him too.
Aww. Don't worry, Sora. You could still see Roxas. Because he's inside you.
All right, let's go.
Secret answer port number 12. Man, we're just getting answer ports. Jeez. But yes, we now know that Roxas is Sora's nobody. Man, and Roxas' story, it's just so sad. And later on, for like the other Kingdom Hearts games, you'll learn more about Roxas and his character. And the story for Roxas, it just makes you feel so sad for him. Yeah, like his story is just so tragic. And but yeah, we'll learn more about Roxas and like in the other games, but for now, yeah. But anyway, we managed to take down Saix, which is good. Now the only member left is Xemnas, the leader. Now, how is he gonna respond to this? Well, we're just gonna have to find out. I wonder what this castle was built for. It's pretty mysterious. That's a good question. We don't know exactly how this castle was made. Gah, I'm exhausted. Let's rest before we go. So all of you were on adventure while I was living a normal life? Why do I always get left out? You're gonna have to tell me about it later. Oh, see, this is what I'm talking about. Like, they always make Kairi to dance on the stress. They never let her do anything at all. Which is why I said last episode, I hope in Kingdom Hearts 3, they make Kairi an awesome fighter. And you can play as her. That's all I'm asking, Square Enix. Make it happen. I met Roxas because of a guy named Diz. Or Ansem, if you want to call him. I didn't trust Diz at first, but we both needed each other's help. And with both members down, the barrier is now open. We can now move onward. But hold on a second. Just do something here real quick. Hold on. God dang it. Alright. Okay, come on. Okay, I'm good. Alright, just have to do something real quick. I wish I could fight like you and Riku. I know what you're thinking, but you guys shouldn't be the only ones getting hurt. Ugh, again, she's making another point. I mean, the thing about this I don't understand is that Riku gave her a Keyblade. Why is she not use it here and now? I mean, sure, she may not be an expert like Sora and Riku, but at least make her fight at least something, not just like two shadows and that's it. I mean, come on. You're missing a perfect opportunity for Kairi and... Please, Square Enix, please, I'm begging you, make Kairi do something awesome. That's all we're asking, please. I know you can do it. The path is open. Xemnas is waiting up ahead. He's the leader of Organization 13. Try not to slow me down, Sora. Same thing to you, buddy. Alright, let's see. You already wasted my ethers, Donald? Really? Come on. How much stuff am I... And Goofy, you wasted all the potions. Jeez. You guys keep on wasting everything, don't you? Alright, but anyway. Like Riku said, only Xemnas is left. So let's go and take him down. Uh-oh. Something wrong?
Ansem?
I'm a fool. I spent years studying the workings of the heart. Yet it seems I still haven't learned a thing.
What do you mean?
The process of encoding hearts is incalculable. The inhabitants of my Twilight Town were data created from real hearts. I was convinced that they would think and behave the way I had envisioned, but I couldn't have been more wrong. A heart is so much more than any system. I saw it when Roxas and Kairi crossed paths. I knew, but I was too stubborn to accept it. It's always the same. I try to wrap my mind around things my heart already knows, only to fail. While I was trying to bring Sora back, I had so many plans in store. But once Sora was an acting force, they fell apart. All my research amounted to nothing compared with that one boy's heart.
Well, Sora is unique.
Ansem, I'm ashamed.
All the more proof that hearts cannot be contained by data. Run, my friend. It's going to self-destruct, and anything could happen.
But, Your Majesty!
Sora, the rest is up to you. And Roxas, I doubt you can hear me, but I am sorry.
Ansem!
My heart is telling me what I must do. Please allow me to do what it says.
No! Riku!
His heart's decided. We can't change that.
I was wondering, who would dare interfere with my kingdom hearts? And look, here you all are. How convenient for me. Ansem the Wise. You look pathetic.
Have your laugh. I deserve as much for failing to see you for the fool you are.
Ooh.
Students do take after their teachers. Only a fool would be your apprentice. After all, none of this would have happened without you. You are the source of all Heartless. It was your research that inspired me to go further than you ever dared.
I admit, my disregard brought chaos to more worlds than one. But what were you seeking? You erased me from the world, only to take my name and continue research better left forgotten. Is this the answer you've been looking for?
All that and more. I'm carrying on what you yourself began, and I'm creating a brand new world. One heart at a time. I thought you'd praise me, but all you ever do is hold me back. I understand, though. Unlike me, you have a heart, and you're powerless to control it, consumed by the jealousy you feel toward the student who surpassed you.
They are not. Foolish apprentice of a foolish man. You have surpassed nothing, only proved how little we both know. We may profess to know the heart, but its essence is beyond our reach. We're both ignorant, as oblivious as when we began. I'm afraid that any world you try to create, any world of yours would be an empire of ignorance. That is why you and your creation are destined to fall. We've said enough. Riku, you know what to do. King Mickey, my friend, forgive me. Farewell.
Oh, man. I mean, despite all, you know, despite all that Ansem's done, at least he's trying to redeem, like, do one good thing by sacrificing himself to destroy Kingdom Hearts. Whether it was a noble sacrifice or not, eh. Oh, look at that. Their hearts raining from the sky. And of course, the nobodies are like, gimme, gimme, gimme hearts. Gimme, gimme, gimme. But unfortunately, since, you know, we destroyed Kingdom Hearts, all the hearts have been released, and look at that. Now we got like a huge army of Heartless on the loose now, which is not good.
Riku!
Oh, he's back to normal.
Riku!
Wow!
Riku!
Ansem did say anything could happen.
Yeah, he did. But he's gone now.
Riku, you gonna take that off?
Oh.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you don't need that anymore.
What was that?
His eyes couldn't lie.
Lie? And just who were you trying to fool? Huh? Huh?
Myself.
Riku, come on, man. Why did you try to do so much on your own? You've got friends, like us.
Yeah, you don't need to do anything alone anymore. Not when you got us. Because no matter what, we're friends. And friends stick together to the end.
Have you forgotten? I'll tell you why. Because I'm not a total sap like you.
Say that again.
That's not good. Oh, that's even worse.
What should we do, Riku?
We must defeat Xemnas. He's the organization's last survivor.
Right.
Oh, look at Riku's outfit.
Come on.
Oh, that outfit looks awesome. Another answer report. Jeez, how many are we getting? Oh, look at that. Yes. So finally we have Riku as a party member. That's awesome. And let me tell you, Riku, in my opinion, is the best party member ever in the entire game. Trust me, having Riku in your party, you should have him, because he's the best. Oh boy. Damn, nobodies.
Take this.
Oh boy. Die. Oh boy. Thanks, guys. But you know what? I think I might end it right here, guys. Seems like a good time to do it. I was thinking of going even more, but you know, I think we should end it right here. It seems like a good time to do it. So yeah, I'm gonna end it right here, guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, because, you know, we fought like a couple boss fights, we learned some interesting plot elements, or story element, just important stuff. And yeah, but the real fight is still yet to come, guys. So yeah, so next time, we shall make our way onward and hopefully take down Xemnas for good, since he is the last member of the organization. So yeah. Hope you guys are looking forward to that fight. So this man has to take over here, and I shall see you guys in the next episode. See ya.